Thank you. Well, it's been been a very boring night. The feds have made a lot of announcements. It came out one time and fired at a few people who were standing up here on the concrete barrier like I am. That was it. They went back inside. So I don't know. I'm gonna stick around for about 45 minutes, half hour, 45 minutes. If nothing happening, I'm gonna call it a night. Consider myself lucky. So, nobody's really doing anything. Everybody's just standing around, chanting. No good cops in the racial system. ACAB, etc., etc. Maybe the reason they haven't attacked is because I'm not in the front no more.
Yeah. special markets in that, right? Very few.
What?
There aren't really a whole lot of federal marshals in there.
Yeah. Let's go see what's happening behind the building, see if we can get some of the popo. Civilians that the feds have injured. Right through the gas mask. Reporters. Now, you didn't miss anything. It is very, very quiet. They came out one time and they shot some pellets at us, but then they went inside. So they've had a bunch of warnings, but nobody's really doing anything. So I don't know. I'm actually taking a walk around the building. It's very, very, very kind of boring. I'll show you the fence. So this is like the fence. They got a new concrete barrier out on the outside and the inside. So. I think I pulled a muscle. Oh, I haven't put the new helmet on because I gotta get some stickers to put press, because it really stands out, and I wanted to stand out with press on it. So I just got it today. I'll be wearing it tomorrow. Oops. Right. Need to climb up here. Yeah, so what I'm going to do with this helmet, I'm going to put a GoPro in this helmet. Are you going down further? So, you can tell there's got a lot of reporters and stuff up on top. Tomorrow I'll get my new gas mask, so I'll be like, you know, a lot better. I'll show you what the crowd looks like. There's a few hundred here earlier. Yeah, I'm not sure if we broke 1,000. We got pretty close. Probably around 900, I would estimate. But this gentleman is walking there, cargo shorts, his button-down shirt, and holding a flower.
The same gentleman was trying to jump the fence earlier, got over the fence somehow, over here, walked around the front of the courthouse. He now has a flower and he's sitting inside the fence. The crowd is out here. He is in there.
Yes, he's in front of that, inside the fence.
The feds have already warned that if anybody was to breach the fence, that they would be shot upon. Not sure how this is going to play out.
Yes. Yes, he's inside. He's being, he's holding a flower.
Starting a fire between the metal fence and the cement wall. I believe he just wrote a phone number on his forearm. Protest zone.
So that was a firework dropped right by me. I mean, it's like 10 feet, no, about 8 yards away from me.
The debris of that actually physically hit me. The crowd is obviously pissed that somebody blew up a fire tactic in amongst the crowd. This guy is still inside the fence.
No, he's writing the number for the legal department. He wrote that number down.
Go ahead.
everything. Come over the fucking fence. Come over the fence. Don't let them win.
Plan is just walking towards the front door. He's now being shot with pepper spray. I'm sorry, he's behind the post. I can't see him. He's still getting pepper sprayed. You can see the smoke clouds coming out from the pepper bullets or rubber bullets or whatever those munitions are. Still getting pepper sprayed. The crowd is chanting Black Lives Matter. I'm just waiting to see what happens. This gentleman is still over here hanging out with his flower.
So I guess they were waiting for you to show up, Karma. So, we have one person over there by the portals. I can't see him, but he went behind the post. All I can see is a cloud of pepper spray coming out. And we still have this gentleman right over here, holding a flower. He's getting ready to walk over there. He's got a mask. It's a cheap little paper mask and glasses. Nothing else, no other, dress shirt, some khaki pants. All right, here they come, here they come. They're coming out right now.
Federal officers have just come out of the building.
Okay, lately they've been doing headshots, so we gotta be careful because all the reporters are up here on top.
There are a few officers outside the door. They do have it open. They're throwing water bottles and some kind of tiny firecrackers into the side of the fence. This guy is still over here in the corner. Inside the fence.
They put the other guy in.
Pepper sprayed. I don't know where he is.
They just brought him inside. That's what the team has to do.
Inside. It looks like the officers up on the front steps pulled him in.
So I expect them to sit there and take some shots.
They're throwing a few water bottles at the officers as they retreat back inside the courthouse. Well, they're firing pepper balls at somebody. Not sure what. This guy's still inside the fence. They just gave him a helmet. The crowd did. Got a helmet now. Lots of banging on the fence. Okay, it looks like the feds just came out to take in the guy that got to the front door. They pepper sprayed him, or pepper ball sprayed, or whatever you call it, him, and then pulled him inside. This gentleman still has his flower over here.
Somebody handed him a helmet. He's now wearing a helmet. This is a front thing.
You're
Hey, the feds have must have got orders to be very volatile today.
What's your objective, man? What's your plan?
To make people realize that the First Amendment is important.
What is being inside the fence make that happen for you?
Because I think that people that stand up against tyranny and people that stand up for their First Amendment rights are the Americans, not the people that are occupying a city that they don't care about.
Do you plan on being arrested?
I don't give a shit. All I care about is my First Amendment rights. It's everybody's First Amendment rights.
And what does being inside this fence mean for your rights? How does just, that prove
just,
anything?
It's just an avenue. It's just a catalyst for me to be able to show my care. I'm probably gonna get arrested.
You wanna state your name for the record?
Are you worried about being hurt?
A little bit. Yeah.
Do you want your name out there so people can know what you're doing?
Yeah, I'm a winemaker.
Okay.
My name's Aaron Coe.
Say that again?
Aaron Coe, A-A-R-O-N-C-O-E. And I'm not afraid of these assholes.
What do you mean?
I still want to give them a rose because this is our city. I want to offer up peace. I don't think they're going to take it though.
You had an open conversation with them. What would you say to them right now?
What?
I can't even hear you, man.
I would say, listen to us. Listen to the people that care about our city. If Trump is touting states taking care of themselves, and then all of a sudden setting in stormtroopers and federal agents unannounced and uninvited, that's unconstitutional. That's why I'm here. That's why I don't care if I get fucking arrested.
Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter! Black Lives Matter!
Well, they grabbed the other guy that jumped the fence.
Here's the young kids coming in with him.
Don't be afraid of these goons. Don't be afraid of the goons. Come over.
Come
over. Don't be afraid of the stormtrooper. Come over.
They don't have a following now.
This is the same kid that was before. He has a hammer in his pocket for sure. He's the one that started the fires earlier in the middle, along with his friend here in the red jacket.
We are the people. We have the strength.
He has a water bottle of some kind in his hand.
That's what they need.
thought better of that, which is smart of him.
This is why they created the Second Amendment.
Just for the record, you are not with the press, correct? Your helmet says press.
I'm a winemaker.
Winemaker, all right. Copy that.
George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd! George Floyd!
Firework in a pit over there where there used to be a building.
Come over and
think they know he's living in there.
Still around pacing with his flower.
Thank you.
He just walked to the door and they found the trap, a couple of them in the dirt. You fly two layers of fence and then walk through the door. You didn't say something.
Fight for you guys.
I think that's what all these people are out here to do, but I think you being on that side of the fence when the feds said that's not a good idea.
I don't give a shit what they say because they're not supposed to be here. They're here unlawfully.
They're unlawfully here when they're out here on the street. They're not unlawful when they're in that building.
Well, I am not on their sidewalk. I am officially...
At this second, you're correct.
I'm officially on a barricade.
Yeah.
So technically I'm not on their property.
That is true. This is the fence that the Portland City has told the feds is illegal, and they're fining the feds for every 15 minutes $500.
Yeah,
so
well,
you are correct.
I'm pretty sure that Governor Brown is going to, if they don't kick my head in and kill me,
yeah,
because they're a bunch of fascist Trump fucking assholes.
Can we get you to take your press sticker off?
I gave him my helmet. Take the sticker off.
Yeah, the press sticker is not.
I don't have a press sticker.
You do. You have stickers all over your helmet.
I'm not pressed.
Yeah, that's what's confusing people.
I'm not pressed.
No, just still, we can fix it. Yeah.
Well, now they're really gonna kill me. I was protected. Thanks, asshole.
I don't want to get hurt.
Yeah, sure, whatever. Yeah, no, I'm happy to be your sacrificial lamb. That's cool.
Thank you.
That is good news for you. People gotta stand up, man. This is why the Second Amendment was created. I don't advocate killing people, but I do advocate our rights as American citizens to not be violated by the federal government, which is exactly why it was created.
Hey, buddy, hold on 1 second. Come over here so we can put some tape over it for you.
Over the press side. Other side of the helmet.
Is that a bullseye? What is that?
This is a fucking piece of tape. Come on. You're on the other side of the press.
Other side of your helmet. Yeah, there you go.
Thank you. Here we go.
So you guys are just getting rid of all liability is what you're doing.
No, it's making it clear to everyone that's taking pictures that you're not pressed. That's the key to this scenario.
Yeah, well, I'm not fucking pressed.
Pushing his luck now and wandering towards the front door. So far, there's been no response against this gentleman with the flower from the federal officers.
Thank you.
appreciate you being out here.
It's going the right way. It doesn't go here.
Guys on the stairs now with his flower. So far, still no response.
Hey! Oh shit, I thought they were coming the wrong way for a second. Chad, no beer.
Yeah. The flashing lights, that means the portal is probably open. If the portal's open, they could be getting ready to come back out.
And they're opening that.
The little hatch above the door is open?
The hatch above the door, but there's the portals to the right of the door is open.
Yep.
For the
lights. I'm not sure if they can see him from the angle of the room. I don't think they can.
I know, but there's...
I know, they can see him, but I don't think the guy who's actually looking for him can see him because of that angle.
Right.
Oh, they know this. They have notes. The federal officers have opened the hatch above the main door on the courthouse. Sure what that's going to happen with that. This gentleman is still over here in the corner holding his flower. He's coming open and close above the main door.
I wouldn't be surprised if they would come up from this side to kind of camp out.
Thank you.
gentleman in here.
Decided to join over the fence. Now the water bottle.
It's kind of like this guy stands out really easily. It's
highly likely that I'm going to get some pellet spray here because of this guy. So we launch the firework to the front door.
He jumped the fence real fast. Oh boy, the floor guy still there. They're shooting me out of the trap door, I do believe. Right over there is the truck door. We got a small fire going off over there at the end.
Okay. We have time to do it first.
Garbage that they've thrown to the side of the fence and started a small fire on the cement sidewalk in front of the U.S. courthouse. protesters just threw some fuel of some kind into that fire over there, made it light up a little more. There's definitely a few agitators who are in the crowd starting to find their stuff right now. I guarantee there's probably going to be some tear gas here soon.
out here.
.55 guys, the first big firework just went over the fence, made a big boom. There was obviously some other small fireworks and things of that nature, some small fires of the trash inside earlier. But right now there's a few hundred people out here.
He's still inside the fence. Okay, good. Go. Maybe he's trying to get their attention. So maybe the feds are using a lot of restraint tonight. For some reason. He did once, but I don't know. He's just kind of sitting there.
Thank you.
That's a good idea. I'll bring one down tomorrow. I should hand it to the Rose guy, have him do it. It's like every city, so every just sitting around, standing around. There's some Rose guys sitting over there. I saw that one coming. We have a gentleman right over there on this side, on the other side of the fence with a rose. Just waiting, he says. a lot of good little interview we had with him earlier.
The Patriot Act was passed, I mean, they gave them a little oversight. Definitely.
to come back over the fence?
Roach gave me the ones that
Aaron, you want to come back over the fence? There's still a few hundred people still here. Aaron, you ready to come back over? Okay, there goes Aaron. We just need the time to come out and get him.
He's getting closer to the door.
So far, he's never been shot at yet, as I know of. Pay attention to that right over there. That's where they'll shoot from. I hate when he gets between us and the portal, because if they shoot, they'll be shooting right at us. Aaron, you about
Richard,
ready to come back over? Over there.
Also, we haven't had a running team for a minute that weren't
Sorry about that, guys.
I'm still worried for this man.
Aaron, you ready to come back over?
Come on over!
no rain over on this side.
Yeah, it's been over there for about an hour. Some more garbage caught in fire.
So also, you won't be able to see it very well, but we're watching.
Okay. I'm about ready to call it a night, people. I mean, Aaron's sitting over here for like an hour, walking back and forth, going up to the front. I didn't have to mess with them, so. Again. Gonna do it.
Great. Also, did you file those TPS reports?
Here comes Aaron again. Aaron came back. He came back this way. He's ready to fire. Uh-oh. He just got lit up.
Yeah.
fire. That is, that's a big charge, I guess. Shooting at something. Brian's on fire down there. We did that other night, they shot a sign and caught the sign on fire. Over the fence. He's back over there.
Thank you.
corner of the side. Big.
Isn't up there?
They're up top.
Pick up the guy at the reach. Defense.
Fuck what they say. We at the protest like every day. Hip hip hooray if I raise my fist. Yes, fuck all these motherfucking pigs. Y'all know what it is. I'm not rocking flips. Plus, I'm taking them off. My middle finger staying up to the cops. I stay dipping off. We up on the streets. So calling police. It's time to leave. Fuck all the F to the E to the D to the F. I stay on the quest. Let me get this shit right off of my chest. I get up. Don't know what is up. I just tend to crush. I bust on the mic like a boom. I uppercut a cop, send his ass to the moon. Fuck your whole crew. Fuck you little bitches. I come to school and now you know that I switch it. Flip it. Look. Listen up. I don't give a fuck. I'm beside the truck. Then I gotta go home. Stay up in my zone. I'ma hold the microphone like a motherfucking girl. I'm a pro when I rip it up. I don't really quit. Fuck the little pig. Need to suck a fucking dick. And I bust like this. And I bust my shit. Fuck fans. They can suck my dick. And I got Adidas. And I'm rapping in the speaker. Fuck police. So it's time for a leader or at least two. Organized. Putting up a fight. Put your hands up. We going fucking unite. Yes, sir. And yo, shout out to medics. Fuck all the cops. Cook them up for some breakfast. They trying to put little bullets where my head is. Fuck all that shit. We do this out to Texas and Portland. Yo, we making a difference. Up in the instant. Yo, I gotta spit, it's the different shit. It's the revolution and it starts with the fucking human evolution. Yeah. And I'm chilling by the cones, getting in my zone, and I flow like a pro. So fuck all the feds, we don't listen when they speak. Fuck the police, we gon' get it in the streets. We gon' make a difference and we setting the example. Shit, my shit feel heavy like an angel, throwing it down every time we in the town. You already know that we be rapping with the sound. Yeah, hey,
thank you. Oh yeah, fuck the feds, fuck the feds, fuck these bitches.
We don't fucking listen to what they say, they can eat shit. Fuck these motherfuckers, yo, we're making a difference for real.
Hell yeah, thank you guys.
Here I come.
You can find me on Twitter or Instagram, No Shoes For Me, N-O-S-H-U, number 4, me. Thank you, yeah, let's do it.